Hello students, if you are preparing for the upcoming Capgemini Drive, then this is a very important video for you. This is the video about the updated information about the pattern, topics and questions. This video is based on the inputs from various students who have actually appeared for Capgemini's latest pattern test yesterday. So all the updated details about each section and the type of questions are covered in this video. So don't forget to watch this video till the end because it is going to be very fruitful for you. And before we start, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon for instant notifications on further updates. So let us start. So first, as we know that the first round is going to be a pseudocode round, which is an elimination round. It has got 30 questions and 30 minutes. Most importantly, these 30 questions are divided into two sections with a common timer. Out of these 30 questions, 7 are around theory based MCQs and 23 questions are around pseudocode questions. Now, out of these 7 questions, 2 are on data structures like basics of Q binary number. Remaining 23 pseudocode questions are of medium level. Some questions are easy but time consuming. Apart from that, one more input is that the questions, some of them are based on C and some of them are based on C++. But you need not worry because language does not matter, because most of the questions are mostly checking your concept. So even if you know simple syntax like do, while, common between these two languages, then it is going to work out. Most of the students said that language is not making a problem for them while solving the questions. Most important tip given is you need to solve the second section first, because the first section is time consuming. So first you can go for the second section and then you can come back to the first section and solve. I am talking about these two sections in the pseudocode round itself, because the 30 questions are divided into two sections with a common timer. 15 questions in the first section and 15 questions in the second section. So make sure you focus more on the pseudocode based questions, because the number of data structure questions are very, very less, and you need not worry about the level of difficulty because there are going to be medium level questions. Next, some of the very important updates for MCQ based English communication test, which is again an elimination round. Students who appear for the pseudocode round, some of them are eliminated there only, they cannot give the MCQ based test, and some of them who clear that pseudocode round come for the MCQ based English communication test. Now this test has again got 30 questions and 30 minutes. Now these are the most important topics on which the questions have appeared, and you need to focus on these topics. You need to focus on reading comprehension. There were around 3 passages. The first one was easy, the second one was medium level, and the third one was a little bit difficult. Total 3 passages had total 10 questions. So maybe one passage was having 3, another was having 4, and then 3. Okay. Secondly, important is the closed test passage. Now, what are closed test passages? So closed test passages are basically, there will be a passage given to you and there will be 3 blanks in those passages, 3 to 4 blanks, and you have to fill those blanks with appropriate options. So it is like a filling the blanks, but these blanks are given in the passage itself. Okay, so these type of questions were even asked in TCS last year. So there is a passage, again I'll repeat. In that passage, you will get around 3 blanks, blank spaces, and you have to fill each blank with appropriate words, and options are given for the each blank. So there were total 6 questions based on closed test passages. Apart from that, there were 3 questions based on parajumble or sentence rearrangement. So they will give you 4 sentences which are not in a proper order. You need to put them in a proper order. Okay, so options will be there for that questions also. Then there were 3 questions on direct and indirect speech. So they will give you a sentence in direct speech and tell you to convert it into indirect speech, or maybe they can give you a sentence in indirect speech and tell you to convert it into direct speech, or they can even ask you whether the given question or the given sentence is in direct speech or indirect. Then there is another type of question known as fact, inference and judgment. There were 2 questions based on this type. So basically they will give you one sentence, and after reading that sentence, you need to tell whether that statement is a fact, inference or judgment. Okay. Apart from that, there were 3 questions based on replacement or correction. So there will be a sentence, there will be a part of the sentence which is underlined, and you have to replace that underlined part with a more correct sentence given from the options. Okay. So there will be a sentence underlined part will be there. Replace that underlined part with the options given. You have to select the correct option, which will be grammatically and meaningfully correct. There were around two questions based on synonyms, and there was one error spotting question. So there will be one sentence. They will be dividing that sentence in four parts, and you have to tell in which part of the sentence there is a grammatical error. So these are some of the very important topics for MCQ based English communication test. One thing, we have covered all these topics in our Capgemini specific masterclass, which we had launched earlier. So I'll tell more about it at the end of this video. Before that, let's move to the game based question. Now there are basically four rounds in game based test. So each round is around, you can say, 5 to 8 minutes. Currently, the challenges which the students faced are grid challenge. That is, you can check in this figure, grid challenge was the challenge wherein dots were appearing one by one and you had to remember the dots. And in between that particular activity, you need to tell whether the figure is symmetrical or not. So that was the grid challenge. Second was the motion challenge, which we all these videos we have already posted on our YouTube channel. So this was the motion challenge wherein you need to put the ball into the hole. Then there was inductive challenge based on similarity grids. So there are two grids given and you need to find the similarity between those grids and check which of the two grids in the options have similar rule. Okay. Then there is a deductive challenge. So this was the deductive challenge which we had posted earlier. So currently these four challenges have appeared for students, but maybe students in further batches may face challenges based on switch challenge, digit challenge and inductive challenge, like the challenge which we have to find that which one of the figure does not fit in the rule. So all these challenges we have put on our YouTube channel, and even in our Capgemini specific masterclass we have included three levels of questions. So basically difficulty level wise we have posted our video lectures based on all these challenges. One important tip, the grid challenge is a little bit difficult as the number of dots go on increasing. So what I mean to say is that in this particular challenge, first you need to remember the place for one or two dots, then three dots, then four dots, then five dots, and the level will slowly increase. Okay. So overall you can say this round can be around 20 to 25 minutes. Next, the behavioral competency profiling, which is a non-elimination round. Remember, game based challenge and the English communication test were also elimination rounds. Some students were shortlisted from the English communication test. They came to the game based test. Again, some students were eliminated, and then some of the students gave this particular behavioral competency profiling test. There are around 100 questions for this particular test or this particular round, but time is not known currently. But time, many students told us that time is not the issue which was found. You can easily answer these 100 questions very quickly. So all these questions do not have a right or wrong answer. So basically, as I have posted on the screen, so there will be a sentence and you have to tell your individual or personal opinion about that sentence. So whether that sentence applies to you or does not apply to you. So these are the type of behavioral competency profiling test. After you submit this particular test, they even mail you one personality report on your email after you complete this test. So these are some of the latest updates we have got regarding the Capgemini specific preparation. Now I would recommend you to prepare with our Capgemini new pattern specific preparation pack, that is the Capgemini masterclass. We have included 400 plus pseudocode questions with solutions. There is a pseudocode based test series. There are video lectures of pseudocode as well as test series. There is a MCQ based English communication test for practice on the topics which we have discussed in this video previously. There are also basic verbal ability lectures to clear the concept on those particular topics. There are 180 plus level wise game based aptitude questions. I mean to say that there will be level 1, level 2, level 3. Slowly the level of difficulty will be increasing, and we have created those questions. Apart from that, there will be 150 plus behavioral competency profiling questions given to you in the form of PDFs, which will be useful to you to understand what type of questions will be there. Apart from that, we are also giving one mock interview, which will help you prepare for the technical and personal interview. Apart from this Capgemini specific preparation, we are giving you an add-on, that is a C programming course from basics to advanced, because many of the students are still not clear with their programming concepts. So you can use this course to prepare, or you can use this course to clear your basic concepts. apart from that, we are giving a complete aptitude preparation video course, which will be useful for other companies. So it should not happen that you purchase this pack and it is limited to just Capgemini. But definitely this aptitude course will be useful for you for all the companies which might come to you in the future for your campus. So thank you for watching this video. If you like the video, then don't forget to press the like button and also subscribe to our YouTube channel with the bell icon to get instant notification of future updates. Thank you.